Have you ever jacked in? Have you ever wire-tripped? No? A virgin brain. Well, we're gonna start you off right. This isn't like TV, only better. This is life. Yeah, it's a piece of somebody's life. Pure and uncut. Straight from the cerebral cortex. You're there. You're doing it. Seeing it. Hearing it. You're feeling it. It's about the stuff that you can't have, right? Like running into a liquor store with a .357 Magnum in your hand, feeling the adrenaline pumping through your veins.
I can make it happen. I can get you anything you want. Just have to talk to me.
Talk to me.
Talk to me.
Talk to me.
I am your priest. I am your shrink. I am your main connection to the switchboard of souls.
I'm the magic man. The Santa Claus of the subconscious. You say it. You even think it. You can have it.
Are we beginning to see the possibilities here? You know you want it.
Welcome back to our humble San Diego podcast. I am your host, The Swan, and this week we say goodbye to the month of November with none other than our good friend and local projectionist, Mr. Chris Pawlak. How are you, man? What's up?
I'm not good. I'm in a shit mood today. Tonight, I should say. We're recording at night.
Tell us more about this.
I won't get into details. You've heard this story at least twice. All right. You've heard it twice tonight, so I won't bore the rest of the audience with it, but have not had a great week. Did not have a good experience with Toyota last week. Got fucked by Pep Boys today. Not happy on that. Got news on another front yesterday that I was not happy about and was very disappointed to get. So not a good week, so I'm in a bad mood today. But I'm happy to be here doing the show with you. It's always fun hanging out with you. So thank you for having me.
Yeah. No, thank you for coming through. I'm sorry that all this stuff is happening to you at once.
At the holiday period, no less.
Yeah. But hopefully this show is a silver lining.
It is. It always is, man. I like sitting down and talking movies with you.
Very nice. All right, so this week, Chris has hijacked the show once again to talk about the criminally underrated Catherine Bigelow film Strange Days with episode 246, Eve of Destruction. But first, here's some of our usual warm-up segments.
And now for a special news report, brought to you by Drop the Mic.
So for Pop Culture News, man, do you have anything for us this week?
I do not.
Okay. Because we are in the weird kind of holiday area, there wasn't too much new stuff that's mm-hmm. come out. But I did find a kind of fascinating piece that I'll throw out real quick. So recently, a North Korean man was sentenced to death by firing squad for giving bootleg copies of Netflix's South Korean show Squid Game to North Korean teenagers.
Uh-oh.
It's fucking harsh, dude.
No, North Korea is not the place to fuck up.
Yeah. I know it's not funny because it's real, but that's fucking gnarly. Have you seen any of Squid Game yet?
No, I know like its pop culture footprint.
Yeah.
But have not checked it out.
It's like the new Battle Royale, I guess.
Yeah.
Somewhat.
SNL did a pretty good parody of it a few weeks back with Rami Malek.
I should check that out.
Yeah, it was pretty funny.
Yeah, and that's the only thing that really, I think, stuck out, unless you have anything on the tip.
It's been a busy week, and it's not a very pleasant week. It's been already established, so no, I don't have anything on the news front.
Gotcha. Alright, how about weekly recommendations?
I have two. They're kind of timely, a little bit too late on them as per the airing of this show, but okay. I'm going to throw them out there anyways.
All right.
One is because the 22nd, which was from the date of this recording, which was Monday of this past week, was the 58th anniversary of the JFK assassination.
Okay.
I want to recommend JFK by Oliver Stone. Kind of try to make it a point to do a rewatch of the movie every year because it's one of my favorites. I think it's probably Stone's magnum opus. I suppose you could argue for Platoon taking that spot, but man, JFK is such a phenomenal movie. Like, I know that a lot of it gets very conspiracy theory, but man, just the cinematography and the direction and the editing and the way it changes between the 16mm and the 35mm and like the black and white and the color and the real footage and the recreation stuff and the narrative of the film is amazing. It's got a cast that is incredibly stacked. I mean, Kevin Costner, obviously, Tommy Lee Jones, Joe Pesci, who's awesome in the movie. Walter Matthau, Jack Lemmon. John Candy, who's fucking good. So good in one or two scenes. Laurie Metcalf is fantastic in it. Donald Sutherland. And probably 50 other people that I'm fucking forgetting right now. Sissy Spacek, who plays Kevin Costner's wife. But I highly recommend that movie. It is a long one, so be prepared. But it moves so well. It's so well done. It is so fascinating. And I'm blown away every time I watch it. Kevin Bacon's another one who's in it.
Is it streaming anywhere?
I don't know. I own it. It is Warner Brothers. It may be on HBO. Maybe on Showtime. I know Oliver Stone just had a documentary, like a JFK documentary on Showtime that aired. So it's possible. It could be streaming on Showtime somewhere. But I highly recommend it. If you can find the director's cut, which I think is kind of the one that's the most easily available at this point in time. It adds about 20 extra minutes. Maybe it needs it, maybe it doesn't, but the movie does not lose anything by those extra 20 minutes. It's just more fascinating stuff in the movie. Highly recommend it.
I was trying to see if it doesn't look like it's streaming anyway.
Bummer. But hey. Buy physical media, people. Buy physical media, as we'll find out when we get into the text of this show, the subject matter on this film, is a good point for why you should buy physical media, because not everything is on streaming, unfortunately.
All right, JFK.
JFK. The second one I have is a great holiday movie. A Thanksgiving movie, so a little late on that, but always a good time for a great movie like this, and that is Planes, Trains, and Automobiles, which is a film that I love, that is really funny, has a really great dramatic turn in it, has a really great performance by John Candy, who, as I just mentioned, is so phenomenal in the two scenes that he's in JFK, in a dramatic role. And while this is a comedy, it definitely has its dramatic undertones, especially the last act or the climax of the film. And man, it's a shame that John Candy died relatively young, because I think that he could have had a great kind of second career or late career resurgence as a dramatic actor, because he's so good in playing up the drama that occurs in Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. So I highly recommend that. Like I said, it's a Thanksgiving movie. Kevin Bacon also makes an appearance in that one as well. A blink and you'll miss it cameo. And Steve Martin is awesome, and he and Candy have such great chemistry with each other. Really great movie, really underrated movie. One of these years we'll talk about it as our Thanksgiving episode.
All right. I just have the one, which I'm going to throw out again because it's getting... It continues to stay very good. Yellow Jackets on Showtime. And I thought it would be cool because it stars Juliette Lewis.
That's right.
As well.
Who is we're going to talk about it.
Yeah. So check that out if you haven't already. I think they're only on their second episode.
Yeah, I've got it set up to record to the DVR, and I think there's only two episodes that have aired out of, I believe, 10.
I don't know what happened with that pilot episode, but there was definitely like a two-week stretch that the second episode didn't come out. I felt like I was waiting so long.
Maybe you saw it like as like an early preview.
Maybe that's why.
And they waited until the second episode. Yeah, but I am recording it to the DVR per your recommendation.
I think you're gonna dig it, dude.
I've liked the trailers I've seen for it so far, and it's got a good cast.
All right, then that'll move us into our main focus, unless you got anything else you want to talk about.
Nah.
No?
Nah, let's hit it.
All right. So we're here to talk about Strange Days. It's rated R. It's from 1995. It runs at 2 hours and 25 minutes, and it's got a kind of low 65 on Rotten.
That's extremely low, but then again, as we'll get into, this is not a movie for everyone. This is a very rough, gritty movie.
Yes. Directed by Kathryn Bigelow, written by James Cameron and Jay Cox, starring Ralph Fiennes, Tom Sizemore, Angela Bassett, Juliette Lewis, Vincent D'Onofrio, and Michael Wincott. The film spins the story of an alternate future within the last 2 days of the year 1999 as ex-cop Lenny Nero is forced to use a black market technology to investigate the murder of his close friend, which in turn uncovers a conspiracy involving vast police corruption. In the mid-80s, famed director and screenwriter James Cameron came up with the concept behind Strange Days, but it wasn't till the early 90s with the events of Rodney King and the Lorena Bobbitt trial that the film's social and political structure took form, with Cameron deciding to pitch the idea to Kathryn Bigelow, who took an immediate interest in the subject matter. The two then hired Jay Cox to turn Cameron's treatment into a full-fledged script. The film was first released in a pre-Matrix world on October 13, 1995, and ultimately became a huge failure due to poor marketing and the high concept nature of the content. Although it was critically praised for its innovative camera work and great performances from both Fiennes and Bassett. Overall, the film has gained a cult following over the years, with many considering the film to be among the best of Bigelow's filmography. Although Strange Days did become a huge setback, as she wouldn't have a hugely successful film until 2008's The Hurt Locker. Although the film is frustratingly hard to find, with only a DVD standard version floating around on the internet and no streaming options whatsoever as of now, but with that being said, Strange Days is worth tracking down and taking the ride. Thank you.
Good ride up. As always.
Thanks, dude. Now, since this movie is one that I'm less familiar with, I want to know, like, what is your attachment to it? Why did you bring it to the show and want to hyper-focus on this one specifically?
Well, I mean, the answer is, I absolutely love this movie. I've loved it since the first time I watched it in 1995. I've seen it so many times. It's hands down my favorite Bigelow film.
Okay.
And, you know, she has a handful of fantastic ones. But to me, nothing compares to this one.
Okay.
It's also the one that's probably not easy to get into. We'll probably get into it as we talk about it. But like I said before, it's kind of a rough watch.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty gritty. I'll be very upfront. There's a pretty harrowing rape scene in it about an hour into the film. But I think it was a movie that was ahead of its time, even though the future of the film was only about 4 years removed from when the movie actually came out.
Yeah, yeah.
But if you go back and look at a lot of the stuff that is